Welcome to the back to the hot seat. As you know, we're more than a month past the deadly explosion and sinking of the Deepwater Horizon oil rig in the Gulf. More than 200,000 gallons of oil a day have been leaking a day. State and local leaders have a plan they say would protect our coast, but tell anchor Scott Walker that just like after Katrina, the federal government is dragging its feet.
On Elmer's Island in Grand Isle, the thin layers of oil are gone. The thick oil has arrived.
We've been in many meetings with the Corps. We want them to get off their butts. Excuse my French. I'm telling you that you got to give us a permit because where we plugged up the dams on Elmer's Island, it works.
Governor Jindal and other local leaders asked 4 days ago for approval from the Army Corps of Engineers to dredge and build an 80-mile-long barrier island to protect the fragile wetlands. The Corps said it would be a decision that takes days, not weeks. But they've still heard nothing.
Nobody's objected. Nobody said don't do this. That's historical. Everybody's come together. What could take 5 days to review those comments and issue a permit? Something's not right here.
Plaquemines Parish President Billy Nungesser says the 80-mile-long barrier island is the best chance to save coastal Louisiana.
We could put that barrier island out there and collect most of it on the island and fight the little bit that sneaks by.
It would help Plaquemine, Terrebonne, us, Lafourche, to block this oil from getting in. It's no longer a matter of if the oil's coming. It's here.
Jefferson Parish Councilman Tom Capella says the $350 million price tag on the dredging plan may sound high to some, but not doing it will cost much more.
If that oil gets into marshes and estuaries, the ecological, the economic, and the environmental price tag is going to be 10 times what it would cost to do these dredgings.
On your side, Scott Walker, WDSU News.
All along, as we've been seeing, the president has been promising that he'd do whatever it took to see that our coast and our way of life be preserved.
I will not tolerate more finger-pointing or irresponsibility. The people of the Gulf Coast need our help, and they deserve nothing less than for us to stand up and do whatever is necessary to stop this spill, prevent further damage, and compensate all those who've been harmed already.
Now, joining us for this segment of the Hot Seat, U.S. Senator David Vitter and Jefferson Parish Councilman Tom Capella. Thank you, gentlemen, for being here.
Thank you, Norman.
As you know, a national poll recently indicated that this is not President Obama's Katrina, but in spite of the words coming from the White House, we now have oil washing up on our shores, full throttle. What does that say about the federal government's response, Senator Vitter?
Well, I'm very frustrated over this non-response to the emergency dredging plan. Billy Nungesser, others are exactly right. This was presented to the feds 2 weeks ago. They promised a response within days. It's been 2 weeks. Friday, they promised a response to me within 3 days. It's been 7 days. I talked to the Corps again yesterday. I have had it. Because of that, this Friday, I wrote a letter to President Obama saying, Mr. President, I know you meant your pledge, but it is being broken. There is not proper federal responsiveness specifically about this emergency dredging plan. You need to give us the right answer immediately.
Councilman Capella, you heard Billy Nungesser from Plaquemines Parish say something is not right there. What might that be?
Exactly. This last Monday, I met with Parish President Nungesser, the governor, Councilman Roberts, several officials and parish presidents. Colonel Lee from the Corps was there, and we asked him, we begged him to approve this plan. It's now a week after that. And we don't have an answer. And again, this plan will work. It is a unified plan with all of the parishes. We need this done because as we sit here and speak, there is now oil, not tar balls, not sheen, oil on the beaches of Jefferson Parish, Plaquemines Parish. It's here. The fight has begun, and we need to fight it out in the water instead of in the marshes.
And Senator Vitter, do you expect the president to read that letter himself, or do you expect it to be handled by those around him?
I expect him to see it personally because it was very direct and it was very strong language. And I did that not to be ugly in any way, it was respectful, but to say, Mr. President, you made a personal commitment. It is being broken right now, particularly over this non-response over the emergency dredging issue. We need the right answer immediately.
How does this correlate to what you felt in your effort to get something done during the aftermath of Hurricane Katrina?
Well, I think everybody is beginning to say, here we go again. Now, I hope it doesn't grow in that direction. The president can reverse this immediately if he wants to, but I think everybody is beginning to say, here we go again.
What kind of preparations or what kind of things can you do as a parish councilman and as a local government to fight the oil that's spreading on your own without permission from the White House or BP?
Sure. Well, obviously, Norman, every piece of boom that we have is deployed. We have fishermen from Lafitte, Grand Isle, Barataria, wanting to work to put out boom, to be the, we need more skimmers. We have people that will man their boats, skim the oil off. And so we have the resources. We have the people who want to work. They don't want anything for free. They want to do a good hour, day's work. And every piece of boom that has been provided by BP, we have out. But we need more boom. But this land boom, this dredging is the one that we think is going to work. So as much as we can have our locals working, we want to do that. They're sitting on the docks waiting because they can't do their regular life chores. And so we need the federal government to give us permission to do that.
What would stop local parish leaders from just going out and doing the dredging themselves without waiting for permission?
Well, obviously, in conversations with Parish President Nungesser and President Terrio, that's something that we're going to have to certainly look at if we don't get an answer in a matter of a day or two. But obviously, money is going to be what we have to focus on. I mean, the project is several hundred million dollars that if the federal government approves the plan, and we want them to do that now, the Coast Guard could then tell BP, this is your baby, you have to fund this.
Would you support that, taking action without permission?
I would if it comes to that. Now, technically, Norman, even if the parishes were to act at their own expense, which is not practical, it takes a Corps permit. The Corps hasn't even acted on the permit it would take for others to do the work. It is absolutely ridiculous.
And as they're going through, Norman, everybody in Jefferson Parish and the surrounding parishes, we all love our environment. We understand that there had to be some hoops to jump through, but they have time to do that with the Environmental Protection Service. This plan is natural barriers. It will work. So this is not something that's going to harm our environment and our ecosystem. It's going to protect it and possibly save it.
Norman, last time I talked to the leadership of the Corps was Thursday night. I said, what's the holdup? They said, there's still environmental review. I said, time out. Let's step back. We're talking about heavy oil getting into the marshland. We're talking about a proposal which is nothing more than to build up barrier islands the way they had existed in the past. So how much environmental review does that take to go back to the way it was naturally in the past to prevent and mitigate against heavy oil in the marshland? Let's use some common sense. That shouldn't take weeks of environmental review.
Exactly.
Is this an example of how badly our governmental structure is broken?
Yes. The federal government in particular, the Corps in particular, yes.
What do we do about it?
We need a streamlined system, but immediately in an emergency, we need the president, others with authority to say, we're cutting through this, we have to act now.
The beaches are now closed in Grand Isle.
Right. Beaches are closed as of Friday in Grand Isle. The back bays are open for fishing.
What happens now?
Well, we have to pick up the oil that's there, and we have some skimmers provided, but we need more. We have the people to man them, Norman. We're picking up the oil off the beach. We need to skim it right out in the Gulf, and we need to protect the passes. We've done that with boom. We do need more boom because the currents are so strong at the passes that it's moving the boom around. What will work is this natural sand man-made boom that will keep it out of the inlands. We can pick it up off our beach. It's not pretty, but we've got the manpower and the people that want to work to do that. If it gets in the marsh area, that's when we have our ecological and environmental problem.
Are we at our most desperate point right now, Senator Vitter?
Certainly so far in this episode we are. Hopefully we're going to turn a corner soon, close down the flow of oil, but the oil is coming ashore, so it is getting very desperate.
That's exactly right, Norman. This is not going to it's going to be an ongoing fight until they stop this oil. Then we have a major, major cleanup to do. But as we sit here today, they haven't stopped the leak. That's what we need to do also.
When might you expect an answer from the White House?
Well, I'm hopeful immediately. In particular, Monday, I believe two cabinet secretaries are coming to the state. I'm sending messages to their departments to warn them they better come with answers because it's going to be an ugly visit, quite frankly, if they don't.
All right. Well, we'll be interested to see what develops from that visit. Senator David Vitter.
Thank you.
Councilman Tom Capella from Jefferson Parish. Thank you both for being here.
It's my pleasure.
All right. That's all the time we have now. Thanks to my guests for being here. Now, back to the news desk.